Alright, here's our new project, Neon, the autocross car. It's a little dual cam, 97 or 98, I don't remember. It was a manual. This is gonna be our under $1,000 little autocross demon. It's actually not in bad condition. The only real problem is AC doesn't work in it. That's really the only biggest issue that it has. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna do a couple cheap mods, like the basic stuff. So I'm gonna do the custom cold air intake that I'm gonna go through here. So we're gonna remove all this stuff, get the throttle body. Also gonna do the throttle body from the automatic one that we pulled from junkyard. Hopefully it will fit, because it was from single cam, but I think as long as I replace the sensors, it should be the same. So we'll see. Let's get to it. Shut in there. There we go. Boom. Alright. So we got that. Now we gotta figure out how to route the new intake. Gonna go to here. Should work fine. Sensors. Alright, so the throttle body is fairly self-explanatory here. Gotta pull this plastic cover off. It's a small bolt, looks like an 8. And then you got two big bolts, and then you got two sensors, vacuum line. That's pretty much it. Alright, cool. Let's get to it. This little 8mm out. I feel lazy, I don't feel like going and getting my quarter drive, so I'm using just a wrench, and 3/8 doesn't fit in there, too big. So. Nope, not yet, almost. Alright, then here's our throttle body. Just put it on here for now, because I'm sure there's going to be a lot more modifications required here. Let's pop this guy out. I have my screwdriver somewhere here. There it is. Alright, doesn't want to come out. Let's see. Come on, you stupid throttle cable. Alright, Did not want to come out. Kept going out to cook it. Alright. Sweet. Vacuum line. Right, let's see. That looks like a 13, maybe. I don't feel like grabbing my tools. I'm using my junkyard bag. So you'll see this very cheapy tools. Not sure how that happened. Switch drive on me. So we got those two. Let's see. Now we gotta just get that little guy out and should be home free. This little guy over here. And it's still a 13. Yep. Gotta go shorter. We're pretty much home free. Gotta get this guy out. And there's a couple sensors in it too. That will get out. It's all about agility here. Come on, come on, come on. You can do this. Alright. So that worked. Right here. Now we just somehow gotta get to those sensors and unplug them. Is it kind of like white over here? Unplug this and move it over. I don't even have my decent pliers here. I don't have vice grips or whatever they're called. I'm gonna have a feeling that I might have to go get the actual tools. My junkyard kit working, but not the best.
we go. Boom. Okay.
As long as don't forget to plug it back in, should be okay.
Get to them. Boom, one. And number two. There we go.
Got him.
Alright, so I'm just gonna put this breather hose back on, just so I don't forget later. Because we just rerouted to the side of it. So that way I can actually pull it out.
Y fitting over here. It was kind of like on the both sides of the hose. Alright, so we got our crusty throttle body out. Now what we're gonna do, we're gonna swap the bracket, swap the sensors, put the new one back on, and you of course want to make sure you clean the new one out. Alright, so this is our automatic one. And that's the manual one. You could tell, I mean, you could see that it's quite a bit, automatic's quite a bit larger on the inside than the manual one. So, yeah, it looks like a good 2-3 millimeter larger or so. I mean, the inlet hole looks similar, but if you look at the actual throttle plate looks quite a bit larger. Cool, so first we're gonna take this bracket off, it's 210 mils. I'm gonna put this bracket back on this guy. I'm gonna hand thread them first. Didn't do that. I thought I hand threaded it. Apparently I didn't. There we go. Right, so those bad boys are on. Now we're gonna take the sensors off the manual and put it in automatic. It uses little Torx, or you could do whatever size that is. I'm just gonna do Torx. And if I strip them, then I'm gonna use something different. That's not going well. Let's trip it. Okay, it's probably just a little bit rusty. I think we're gonna have to use an actual socket for that one. It doesn't want to cooperate. Kind of looks almost like a 7 mil. Nope, 8. This thing is finally giving up on me. Alright, let's see. I have a new one somewhere. I just bought a new one. Because that one's been sticking a lot lately. There we go. Let's see, it didn't want to come out. Looks like just rusted in. One sensor. And this one's almost home. As long as we don't strip this one, it should be good. And it does not want to come off. Oh, look, that's why. Look how much torque we've put in it. Alright, let's try a different one. So this one's junk. Alright, let's go big. Go big or go home, right? Right. I think this is T20. Yep, T20. We're going half drive. Sorry, gotta figure it out. Alright, so let's get a razor blade. There we go. I'll make sure that the surface is clean over here. Since you never know with this junkyard throttle body stuff. Sweet. So now let's get this guy out. Same way. The way these bolts are going in. Probably shouldn't do that with an impact, but oh well. Alright, let's see if we can tighten it up a little.
It looks like it's getting in there.
I wish I had torque specs for this. But, oh well. You do what you can, right? Alright, so we got this guy. And now, we gotta get this guy back. Sure, not this guy. This guy over here. And this one's actually using 8mm again. It looks good. Which I do like this better. Some dirt on this O-ring. This from the other one. I think we found out our issue. Alright, so it seems to all fit. Oh yes. But the difference is there. I'm just not sure how much. I wonder if we can just measure it with calipers outside real quick. Where are they? This one looks like it's 50.9, so 51 millimeter almost. I wonder if it's all the squat that makes any difference. Doesn't seem to be the same. But that throttle plate looks so much smaller from the front. Okay, so
From the front, there is a difference from the front. 54. And there's like 3 millimeter difference almost. Alright, cool. And now we're gonna try to put it back. And because we're going cheap, we're not replacing the gasket. Plus it doesn't look cracked or anything, so it should be okay. Hopefully the throttle cable will fit fine. It should, I don't see why it wouldn't. This cable has just been nothing but a pain in the ass to me today. There we go. Alright, we got this guy. Now we're gonna put the sensors back in. But I didn't hear it. I think we got it in. And now we gotta tetris this back in like it was. There we go. Now we just gotta get it all lined up, put some bolts in it. We got this one, but we did not get that one yet. We're aligning perfectly almost. Oh yeah. Probably use extension. We had one somewhere here. There it is. Keep smacking my fingers. Alright. Alright, now we're gonna tighten this back up. Should be all set. Hopefully the throttle is not too tight. I got a couple different elbows over here that we're gonna try. Doesn't seem like it's going much. There we go. Alright, I figured there's probably gonna be lots of butchery going on here. But in order to actually close properly. Let's see, might have to cut it. Let me try a second one, I got two different ones. Somewhere. There it is. Let's see how this will look. Might make two out of one. Vice versa. Move it. Move it, boy. Looks like 13. Yep. That did not want to come out. Ah, it was out of fight. Alright, so this is the contraption we have going. So we have this 3.0 intake from a Dodge Caravan 3 liter going into oil coupler that I made over here, into intake from a 95 Honda Accord that I bought for parts once, parted out but still had intake going from it, and it's using a Spectre filter. This guy over here. And it's all secured by one zip tie, and then I'm just using some hose over here that goes into a breather and it goes into the provision on the intake. You can probably see the clamp, it's kind of hard to tell, and just a standard hose. Here's everything that's been pulled out, all of the parts, so kind of clears the back out a little bit. Still waiting on the mail to get more stuff in. I can still look for my oxygen sensor to replace, because the upper one is throwing CL light once in a while. And once we do that, we're gonna do basic tune-up. But I will tell you, the automatic single cam throttle body does wonders on this car. Man, it feels alive. It feels like a different vehicle. It's pretty awesome. So yeah, the car revs up quite happy in these days with that new throttle body, and it just feels a lot more alive than it did before. It's gonna be kind of hard to do. Oh, car's coming. Oh yeah, like even just like regular driving feels way quicker on this thing.